Hey guys, welcome back to Cornfield Couture. It has been a little bit, and I realized that it's been a long time since I've done a favorites video. I was just sitting around watching like July favorites videos, and I realized that I have a lot of favorites from this whole summer, and I can't even remember the last time I did a favorites video. It had to have been like last year. I definitely have not done one in 2016. So I think it's about time that we chatted about what I've been into. I've tried a lot of new things this summer, and I just kind of have some general things that I've been loving this summer, and I would love to share them with you because that's why we all come to beauty channels, right? It's to talk about material things. So here we go. So for my first favorite, I'm going to go on a little bit of a ramble about coconut oil, which as far as I'm concerned is miracle everything in a jar. The miracle of this over the summer was putting coconut oil on sunburn, which let me tell you, as a very pale person who burns very easily, I don't know how I have lived my life without coconut oil, because it does not take anything for me to burn. I put it on a sunburn that was really bad, and within 2 days, the sunburn was gone. It had just faded into tan, which has never happened to me before. Usually my sunburn peels and then just fades into pale again. Now, like this is tan for me, which I realize is not tan for almost any other human on this earth, but like this is as glowing, summery glow as I get, and it's because coconut oil saved my life. And like I said, within 2 days, the sunburn was gone. It didn't peel at all. My skin was fine and like healthy again. I'm in love with coconut oil, basically. I'm convinced that it can cure anything in life. So that's that. This is the thumbnail for sure. Also for skincare, I have been loving this summer the Mario Badescu facial spray with aloe herbs and rose water. We have it at Anthropology. It's also available at Ulta. I just get it through Anthro because I work there and get a discount. But it's amazing. A lot of people use it to set their makeup. I don't do that. So after I've showered and after I've cleansed my skin, I'll spray this on, and it kind of like puts the hydration back into my skin before I put my makeup on. And also when I take my makeup off, then I put this on and it kind of puts that hydration back into your skin. So it's like a post cleanser product for me. So it's like once you're cleansing, like yes, your face is clean, but sometimes it can be stripped of moisture and freshness, and this is what I use it for. And it's gotten to the point where like I can't be without this. Like once I know I'm getting low, I buy a new bottle because my skin gets really unhappy if I don't have this on my face. And I absolutely love it. I've also started like using it on my arms and legs if I don't have time to put lotion on. But let's be real, it's easier to go ch-ch-ch than to like rub lotion in. So, and it's been working great. I am obsessed with it. It's just so refreshing and wonderful. It's great. So I ran out of the foundation that I had been using, and I decided to try the L'Oreal True Match Lumi Cushion Foundation. That is what it's called. But everyone's been talking about cushion foundations. They're the newest thing. If you are somehow unfamiliar with cushion foundations, let me get the little sticker off. It looks like this. This is like a sponge, and the foundation is under the sponge. I don't use the applicator it comes with. I use a foundation brush, and you just squish it in and put it on your face. And somehow, when liquid foundation is absorbed through a cushion, it makes it better than when it's just liquid foundation. I don't know how that works. I don't know who thought of this, but whoever thought of this owns my heart, because this is so good. This is the third one I've gone through this summer. That is actually one con to it, is I think it does, like, you go through it a little faster than like a bottle of foundation. But I love it enough that I'm willing to keep buying, because usually by the time I've gone through an entire bottle of one kind of foundation, I'm like over it. Whereas this, I keep repurchasing, which I think is a pretty good sign that I like it a little bit. So we'll consider that a solid A. So for lip products, I want to mention a couple things from Anthropology, which I do want to make a quick disclaimer about. I do get Anthropology items at my employee discount. However, they don't pay me to make videos promoting their products. So I just want to clear the air that this is not a sponsorship. If they wanted it to be, I'd be fine with that. But I'm a sales associate. I get paid my sales associate rate. They don't pay me to make videos for them. I just happen to like and purchase their products, which is a good thing since I work there, and it means that I can actually say with certainty that I like the things that I'm selling to people. So in any case, like I said, I do get a discount on products, but that's just because I'm an employee, not because this is a sponsorship deal. And with that, let's talk about these lip products. The first one is in this beautiful gold tube. It's by Albeit, which is an Anthropologie exclusive brand. When I first started in Anthro, it was the only beauty line that we carried was like the Albeit Anthro brand, but now we have like a whole huge range of beauty stuff, which is really exciting. But this one is like the classic Anthro lipstick, and it's in rosewood. I'll swatch it a little bit on my hand here, and I also have it on my lips today. I'm obsessed with this color. It's considered like the universally flattering color in the Albeit line, and it's just so freaking pretty. I love it. It's really moisturizing. I love having it on. It lasts forever. I have noticed that I don't care for the formulas of some of the darker colors, but this rosewood color, I wear it all the time, and it's fantastic. And the next lip product is by Artist Studio, which is also an Anthropologie exclusive line. It comes in like a paper packaging, and it's all like really cute. Every color has a different pattern to the packaging, and that's the whole point of Artist Studio, is like American artists are like commissioned to do the packaging for the line of that season. So this is from actually a couple seasons ago. This is the color Black Cherry, which admittedly, when you look at it in the tube, that looks intimidating. And for like a year of working there, I never touched this because I'm like, no, absolutely not. I'm not gonna wear that. However, I didn't realize it's a tint. So that's it. Super light and flush. And when I wear like purple toned makeup, I always reach for this because it's like a nice purple stain. And yeah, I've liked the formula of it a lot. I think it's a really great product. Some of the other colors are really good too. This is just the only one that I've purchased so far, but I've swatched a bunch of them and I really like them. So if you're looking for a nice lip tint, I think this is a really good option. Next, we're gonna talk about nails, which I love me a good summer nail polish. And for the first big chunk of the summer, I was wearing this, which is Goginza, I think. Yes, Goginza by Essie. I guess you consider it lavender or periwinkle. It's just a super, super light tint of it, which you would think is what I have on my nails right now. However, I do not. What I do have is the new Essie Gel Couture line in Style in Excess with the gel top coat. And the reason why I got this color, I wanted to try the Essie Gel Couture line in the first place. The reason why I got this is because when you look at these, they're almost the same color. And I was such a fan of Goginza. I was like, well, if I'm gonna try it, I'm like, this is a really old bottle of Goginza. I need to replace it. But since I was gonna try this anyway, it's like, well, this is close enough. So maybe this will just be even better than Goginza and I'll wanna use this all the time. I wouldn't say it's better than Goginza. It is a little darker, and I do like that super, super light pastel thing that Goginza has. However, let's just talk about the Gel Couture line for a quick minute. First off, it has made me a believer in top coats. I have not found a top coat that I've liked ever. I've thought that I had. I've liked top coats for like a solid minute before, but I've just found, and maybe it's just my nails, or maybe it's just how I use my hands that makes my nails more susceptible to this, but I found that with top coats, like if I wear a top coat, it chips my nails more, like, cause then it will like come off in a larger chunk with the top coat with it. So I've just never liked that about top coats, and so I've just gone without a top coat on my nail polish for years and years and years. But obviously, if this is a gel line, like you want to try the top coat with it. And like I said, this has made me like a believer in top coats. I've had this polish on for a solid week now. I did repaint over it once, but that is because of my job at Anthropologie. It's a very dry environment. I'm using my hands a lot and my nails just get wrecked. And the fact that I have worked with my hands at Anthropologie three times since applying this, and I've only had to touch up once, That is like revolutionary in my life. So again, I've just painted over with the same color twice now, and I'm crazy about it. I have it on my toes too. It's great. Moving on to some fashion favorites, which are mostly from Anthropologie, because guys, when you get that discount, it really ruins shopping anywhere else for you. So I've been really loving some things that I've gotten at Anthro this summer. One of which is this skirt, which does not look like anything and it's a little wrinkled, but it is a chambray circle skirt from the brand Tina Joe. And yeah, like I said, it looks like just a simple circle skirt, and that's because it is, but it does have some like little distressed detailing on the bottom, which I really like. But this is just one of those basics that I didn't have in my wardrobe and I felt like I needed, and I wear this all the freaking time. It goes with every top because it's plain chambray. Because it's chambray, it can be casual or you can dress it up a little more. But also what I like about it was the length. It is down to my knees, and a lot of my skirts are a little shorter, and I just needed something that was a little bit more professional. I could wear this to an interview if I wanted. I've worn it to a play. I've worn it around Chicago. I wear it all the dang time, and it is just so good. So sometimes you just gotta go back to the basics and get something really simple that you're gonna use a lot, and that is this skirt for me. So I do have a few Anthropologie necklaces that I have to talk about, and I'm gonna just put them on and then like boost myself up here. This necklace is fantastic. It's gold, like a tarnished gold chain with some bars, some pearls, and then this like disc at the bottom. And I love the versatility of this necklace. I think it's really, really easy to just throw on and go with everything. And it's really modern and neat, and I love it. And the second necklace doesn't go with everything, that's for sure, but it is just so beautiful that I couldn't pass it up. Oh my gosh, guys, look at this necklace. It's got these tourmalines and in this chevron pattern, which I'm just a sucker for chevron. And it's got this gold tassel on the bottom, and it's all pretty. I love it so much. I have a new favorite sandal this year. I had to throw away a lot of the sandals that I have had over the years because I wear my sandals, wear all my shoes, just into the ground. And some of my sandals were getting really like dirty and gross and just old and falling apart, and I needed to replace them this year. So one of my replacements was this guy. We'll put it over the white so you can see it a little better. This is the Berkeley sandal, yes, from Maurice's. And I've always been a fan of Maurice's sandals. And this sandal in particular, like, it's a really cool gladiator. I've just been a really big fan of it. It's simple enough that I can wear it with almost everything. This moss color surprisingly goes with everything, and I've worn it a lot. They're super comfortable. I can get through an 8-hour shift at Anthro and not be dying over my feet. They're really great, and in fact, they, I think right now, are on sale, and I just ordered them in a rose gold color too, because I love them that much that I'm fine with having them in two different colors. So yeah, these have been real winners. My favorite TV show of the summer is actually not a TV show of the summer because it ended in the spring. It's The Good Wife, which I've talked about multiple times on this channel. I love The Good Wife so much. It's my favorite show maybe of all time. But the series ended in May, which I'm still mourning because it should have lasted way more than 7 seasons, and the creators who decided that it only needed to be 7 seasons, they're making me a little upset. But the reason why I'm featuring it in my summer favorites is because my mom and I have been binge watching seasons 1 through 6 this summer. We're on season 4. We're like halfway through season 4 right now. And it is so fun to watch like episode after episode starting in season 1 after seeing the series finale, because then it's like you know what happened in the future, and then looking at the stuff in the past that like led to what happened in the future is like, oh my gosh! And it's just, it's such a good show. Seriously, everybody just binge watch seasons 1 through 7. Just do it. Do it, because it will be good for you and you won't regret it. And Carrie Agos is the love of my life. That's the other thing. I watched some movies this summer, two of which were movies from last year that were nominated for Oscars, and so I just felt like now that I have time this summer, I needed to watch them. And those were Trumbo and The Danish Girl. And let me just say, I didn't see The Revenant, but after having seen Trumbo and The Danish Girl, I think that Bryan Cranston or Eddie Redmayne could have definitely won Best Actor over Leo for The Revenant. Just throwing that out there. But the other movie that I saw this summer was Finding Dory. And let me tell you, I loved Finding Dory so much, just as much as Finding Nemo. It was so funny and it was just so good. Just so good. And I was afraid that it wasn't gonna be as good, but it was amazing. And a lot of people left saying that it made them cry. It did not make me cry, which I think is partially why I liked it, because almost every other Pixar movie in the universe makes me leave an emotional wreck. Can we still talk about Inside Out? I'm still damaged from that movie. Also, The Good Dinosaur, damaged from that movie. Monsters, Inc., when I saw it as a child, damaged me emotionally, but I was not emotionally damaged by Finding Dory. It was so good, and I mean, I guess I can see how it was emotional, but not emotionally damaging, which is A plus to me, Pixar. Sometimes on this channel, I like to talk about my favorite beauty YouTuber, and I have been loving the summer Blogilates, Cassie Ho from Blogilates. I've been kind of trying to get into more health and fitness stuff this summer. It's been a little bit of a slow process, but I've been realizing that I need to make some lifestyle choices, one of which involves actually getting my butt off the couch and moving, which, you know, it's a little bit of a struggle. But Cassie just makes it really easy. She's got this beginner's plan and all of her videos like are really good. I will admit that there are some times when she's like, it hurts, but it just feels so good and you're just loving it. I'm like, no, I'm not, I hate you. But at the same time, I appreciate that positivity and motivation, because if she was like, yeah, you probably hate me, don't you? And I'd be like, yes, I'm done. So yeah, it's, you know, all you need is a yoga mat and you can do it at home, which is partially why I love it, because if it involves anything else, I'm not gonna do it. And it's 28 minutes a day. Who doesn't have 28 minutes a day? So I'm really impressed by her program overall. I love her positivity. She does like cooking videos too, which I have yet to try any of them, but I think that they could probably be very good and valuable. So maybe I should give that a go. But in any case, Cassie, you're a new fave. Couple of quick miscellaneous favorites before we wrap things up. First of which is this planner from Target. I am so in love with this planner. It's floral and it's beautiful. It's by Day Designer. Megan Tom just got the same one, but I got it first, so I'm so impressed with myself. But I've gotten Day Designer planners for a while now. I like that they're month plus week, which makes me really happy. And just this floral pattern really just brightens my spirit. I've only gotten like plain ones in the past, but they expanded to like stripes and polka dots and florals. And because I'm an old woman, I love the floral. But I am someone who works better with July through June planners rather than January through December, just because I'm still in school. And by the time like fall hits, I'm already planning for the spring. So if my planner ends in December, that's not working for me, because I'm like planning in advance to like May in December. So I definitely need planners like this, and I appreciate that Target carries them, and they're pretty affordable too. Also, the spine is rose gold. Just thought I'd throw that out there. And last but not least is a company called ThredUp. And you might have seen ThredUp on like your Facebook ads. That's how I found it initially. It was one of those like sponsored ads on Facebook, and it was like online consignment shop, you know, sell your clothes online. I was like, what? What is this? And at first I thought it was like another thing like Virage Sale or like Let Go, where you post your items or whatever. It's not like that. It is literally an online consignment shop for women's clothing, handbags, and shoes. And I have a lot of those. And 2016 has kind of been, especially in the summer, has been my year of like getting rid of stuff and purging stuff out of my life, because I just have too much stuff and it's getting a little cluttered, and that Life Changing Magic is tidying up book, and it has inspired me. So trying to get rid of a bunch of things. The thing about ThredUp too is that it only takes like good quality clothes, name brand clothes, and like not like completely perfect clothing. Like if it's got pilling on it, if it has threads loose, like they won't take it. Which also means you get more money for it. And I also have a habit of being an impulse shopper, and sometimes I buy things and then sits in my closet for like 3 years and never gets worn, and it's still in my closet, new with the tags. And so this year has been my year of deciding no more of that. You're going away. If I haven't worn you in this long, I'm never gonna wear you. You have to leave. So what ThredUp does is they send you a cleanout bag, which I just ordered a new one. So this is it. It's a big plastic bag with a shipping label on it. And you fill it full of clothes, you send it to them. You can either have whatever clothes they don't decide to take recycled and used in, you know, repurposed materials, or you can have them send it back to you. Either way, I've just had them recycle everything that they don't decide to use because I don't want it back. But basically then they sell your clothing that they choose to sell, and then you get money for it, like a consignment shop works. And then you can either use that money to purchase clothes on ThredUp, or you can just get it back cash. So my first bag that I sent, I got $40, which was awesome. I just sent them a second bag. I haven't gotten the price quote of that yet, and I just ordered myself a third bag. So clearly I'm liking this a lot. They are a really good ethical company as well, which I appreciate. I will leave all of their links below. But if you're trying to get rid of stuff and you're female, unfortunately they don't take men's clothing, which I wish they did, so sorry guys. But if you're a woman and you're trying to get rid of some stuff, I would recommend them. They're pretty darn great. And with that, I'll stop rambling and I'll shut this video down, but I thank you so much for watching and listening to me ramble about coconut oil and, you know, all that jazz. That should be the title of the video. Coconut oil and all that jazz. It's not. It's gonna be like summer faves because I'm basic. So anyway, love you guys. See you later. Bye.
Sugar,
ooh, sugar,
you're so sweet,
you're so sweet,
sweet to me.
I can't think
ooh,
about
sugar, you're so sweet, sweet to me.